They starred in some of the most popular TV series of the 90s, Full House, Step by Step, and Seventh Heaven. Now Jodie Sweetin, Christine Lakin, and Beverley Mitchell are all grown up and starring in a new unscripted comedy series called Hollywood Darlings. This is an unscripted comedy, but it's not a reality show, right? So how does this work?
No.
That's right.
We like to call this an improvised comedy.
Yeah.
You know, we wanted to take our friendship and our roles as mothers and as businesswomen and actresses and kind of do something that only we could do. So we play heightened versions of ourselves. And every episode was sort of, you know, there was something from our life that we kind of drew upon, but then we just sort of turned it up to a 12. So we had ideas for each scene, but we'd have a point A and a point B, and how we got there was sort of up to us. So I can only liken it to say that it's kind of like a Curb Your Enthusiasm, but it will feel more like a sitcom, like a Modern Family.
Okay, so it is pretty true to your life, though. These, you're drawing on real life experiences.
We took sort of real life things that had happened to us as like little kernels for, okay, what can we turn this into in sort of a very exaggerated, over the top kind of way. I mean, we, you know, again, we play heightened versions of ourselves, so it's, we found like the particular qualities about ourselves that really differentiated us from each other. You know, I play this very kind of cynical, dark humored person, you know, in the show, that's kind of always, you know, poking at Beverly,
and I
play, you know, the over organized, over prepared Uber mom who's trying to do it all. Not so successfully.
And I'm sort of the, you know, hippy-dippy, lovable idiot in between them two.
Oh, I love it. What do you think made the 90s such an iconic decade for TV?
Well, I think, you know, it was a time which, you know, was much simpler. I think it was much more about family. I mean, we all come from, you know, very strong family shows. And I think that was a really awesome time because it was a very rare occasion, but now people used to actually sit down with their families, parents and children, and watch a TV show together. That is unheard of now, and it's actually quite sad.
But this show also
is not that show. This is more
put the kids to bed and enjoy some adult humor.
Absolutely.
I was going to say.
But if you want great family television, you watch Fuller House. There you go.
Throw it back. Yeah, so what would you rate this show? Because the shows you were on before are like G-rated. Is this R-rated humor? What
Definitely
are we talking about?
Definitely not G-rated.
This is PG-13.
Okay.
PG-13, a little more mature audience. I'd say even a little more mature audience. Some of the things, you know.
I mean, we're definitely like poking a lot of fun at ourselves, and you know, we curse and it's bleeped, and you know, it definitely feels a lot like a like an adult comedy.
Yeah,
so,
absolutely.
But I think what people will love about it, and I think the thing that endures is our friendship, and that part is very real. And
absolutely.
I don't think that we could pull this show off if we weren't really friends.
If we didn't like each other, it would be a lot of work. It would be a long day with y'all.
When did you guys all meet? When did that friendship actually start?
Well, Jodie and I have actually known each other since Jodie was 4, I was 5. We did the Oscar Mayer.
My very first commercial was an Oscar Mayer commercial. We did it together. And
then Jodie and I met when I screen tested for Step by Step when I was 12, and I had like a fan out moment with her. I totally Instagrammed that picture. Like a double chin, so excited. And then I met Beverly when I guest starred as a pregnant teen on Seventh Heaven. You know, over the years, like you have this weird small sorority of people that grew up as child actors, and I don't think you can share an experience that's so unique like that and not have it bond you for life.
Who are some of your dream guest stars for this show? Other child stars or 90s icons that you'd want to have on this?
Well, we actually had a ton of amazing guest stars on this first season. Andrea Barber, Jaleel White.
Andrew Keegan.
Yeah.
Patrick Duffy.
Tamara Mowry.
Yeah.
We got really lucky. You're right. Lance Bass. It's kind of crazy. You know, we're very open, though. We get a season 2, knock on wood.
Yes.
You know, that we can continue to rope some of the
And actually, I think
people.
A lot of our friends now, because they had so much fun, have been telling other people. And I think we've got a lot more people knocking on our door to come play with us, because it was definitely an experience to be remembered.
Yeah.
And you are all part of family-focused shows. Are you still in touch with any of your co-stars?
I'm still working with them on Fuller House, so I see them all the time. But, you know, even before that, I mean, we stayed in touch for the last 20 years. I mean, we're incredibly close. I don't think we've ever really spent that much time apart. So we're kind of abnormal as far as casts like that go.
And I think we're all in a unique experience because we're all only children. So our big families that we kind of grew up with on camera kind of became our pseudo family.
They can't quit us.
They can't get rid of us. I mean, we're all stuck together forever.
Hollywood Darlings premieres tonight on Pop TV.